Hello and welcome to Your Property Empire. I'm Chris Gray. Away from Sky News, I'm part of an entrepreneurs organisation which is also known as EO. Now, EO is a supportive network of entrepreneurs trying to grow their businesses and often doing it at record levels compared to other typical businesses. And quite often they have completely contrarian mindsets to compared to the competitors. Now, whilst a number of our viewers may not run their own business, by understanding how entrepreneurs think, it may well assist you to develop the right property investing strategy that's right for you. And when things are doing things pretty tough, then may get some ideas on how to get more positive. Now, tonight I'm joined by one of the most well-known brands and members of the Entrepreneurs Organisation. Please welcome Naomi Simpson, founder of Red Balloon. I can't even get my words out this evening. So, for the viewers that may not have come across Red Balloon, tell us about kind of how big the business is and how quickly you've grown it.
Well, Red Balloon is an online gifting business, so we give vouchers to experiences. As we like to say, we give people good times. So, in terms of size, this Christmas we'll do about a transaction every 3 seconds, and that equates to about 3 MCG size. Gifts will be under Christmas trees this year.
And so a lot of it's all about the experiences, like rewarding team members, giving presents as families, because a lot of it you do with kind of commerce and kind of team building and stuff, don't you?
Absolutely. Apart from obviously mums and dads and consumers, we also have a very large corporate business. And corporate gifting, it's never too late to acknowledge your clients and your customers and also recognise your people. It's a good time to say thank you, as they say.
Now, you've got a big brand as a business and there's been lots of PR and media around it. It's not always as easy as that though on the outside. So what are some of the hurdles that you've kind of gone through over the years?
You know, I think we've only got a small little section here and there's many to say, but look, the point is it doesn't matter where you sit in business and where you're up to. The thing is you've got to believe in it. You've got to know why you're in business every day. What problem are you solving for somebody? So at your core, what's your purpose? The second thing is it's going to take a bit of persistence, and that is never ever giving up. I remember one entrepreneur saying to me, being an entrepreneur is like being a clown punching bag, you know, a big smile, you punch them and then you just have to keep getting up. And the other thing is, it's definitely about passion. You've got to really feel it every single day.
And talking about a lot of those things, it's like the property investors as well, because property investing's hard. Like, it looks on the outside, it looks, oh, we make a lot of money in the boom times.
Exactly.
But it's pretty tough and having a lot of debt and the rest of it. So we're always talking on the show about getting coached, going to seminars, getting education. Tell us a bit about EO and why something like EO is good for people in business.
Look, EO is fabulous because you can learn from other people's mistakes. So why wouldn't you learn from others instead of yourself? And the uniqueness about EO, it's about peer-to-peer support. So people speak from experience, so they're not telling you how to run your business. And I must admit, I get a bit offended when people go, oh, you know what you should do? And it's, you know, I find that a little affronting. So working with peers, having a very confidential conversation with people, you can learn a lot from their mistakes. The other thing about EO is that we bring in people who are renowned, who from overseas, great speakers, and obviously we learn from these people too.
So again, for the property investors, is why go through all the mistakes when you can learn from other people. Now, obviously, there's a lot of people have talked and we've seen in the media about the story of Red Balloon, but real estate's part of your story as well. Do you want to tell us a bit about that?
Well, actually, my first big investment was in a tiny little flat in Peran in Victoria, and you know, people were listening now, going, "I can't believe that you did that." But I bought it for $80,000 way back. It was last century, and I only kept it for 3 years, but I did renovate it, you know, painted it all white, put in new carpets and so forth. Unfortunately, at the time, interest rates went to 16 or 17%, and I was living on boiled eggs, had a fabulous figure, but anyway, you know, didn't spend much on food, but I took in a boarder. And that really helped offset that. So after 3 years, I sold it for $105,000, which is not a bad return on investment after only 3 years.
And especially getting through 16% interest rate.
Yeah, well, it was four savings. I tell you, I wouldn't have been living that life if I hadn't have done it, for sure.
And so you obviously had a good experience there. What was the next move? Because you've obviously carried on property investing.
But that's what I've done the whole way, is I've bought unrenovated houses, done them up. So moved to Sydney then, when I joined Apple, before I started my own business, bought an unrenovated home for about $270,000 in Balmain, and yet just a few years later it was worth far more than that after we did a beautiful renovation that actually won a New South Wales Design Award. Mm.
And again, places like Balmain, 10 or 20 years ago, they were pretty run down, pretty industrial, and now it's one of the kind of trendy blue chips, isn't it?
When I moved there 23 years ago, there was only one coffee shop. was called Cafe Berlin, you
know. It's probably 100.
Exactly.
So what are the main things? You obviously like renovating. What are some of the other things you look for in property?
Look, I think is looking for uniqueness. That is what makes it special and has an, you know, there's always the typical things of north facing, ease access, close to amenities and all the rest of it. But I'm looking for uniqueness. I'm looking for something that'll sparkle and something that'll also make it a home. Not just for me, but the potential purchaser of who's coming in afterwards.
Now, you've got a lot of young people in your business, which obviously you kind of speak to all the time, and you're on the speaking circuit, so you speak to a lot of people. How tough is it for young people these days?
Well, unfortunately, I think they find it all overwhelming because they read the papers and they think it's too hard. But it's not too hard if you think about it. So I do know young people who have started in the outer suburbs, done exactly what I did, renovated and sold it. Because, of course, being an owner-occupier and renovating while you're doing that, there's no capital gains tax, so you're getting that advantage. So, and literally, with every purchase, they move a little closer to the city. So they do, and they're not keeping these homes necessarily a long time, 15, 18 months, and they're managing to make enough that they get to the next step, and it is forced savings the whole way.
Yeah, I mean, the forced savings, I think, is an amazing thing. And when I started off my journey, I bought a three-bed rather than a one-bed.
Yeah.
Did the same as you and put a couple of renters in. It's not the ideal situation, but in your 20s, hanging out with mates is good fun anyway.
Yeah.
So, good stuff. Anyway, time now for a quick break. We'll be back soon.
By shopping small, you made a big difference. So to the many who shopped small, here's a big thank you. Keep thinking big, keep shopping small. American Express. Realise the potential.
TPG presents our unlimited bundle. Get unlimited ADSL 2 Plus with home phone line rental. Unlimited calls to local and standard national numbers. Unlimited calls to Australian mobile numbers. And unlimited calls to selected international countries. Plus a Wi-Fi modem. All for just $79.99 a month. Yep, $79.99 a month. TPG is a multi-award winner.
TPG.com.au.
At Allianz, we know things don't always go to plan. That's where we come in.
Allianz Insurance. I see you've got our rental car option. Let me contact them now.
Allianz Comprehensive Car Insurance, with the option of a rental car to keep you on the road.
I just wanna build, get it.
You'll be okay with Allianz.
Some are born great.
A new age is coming.
Some achieve greatness.
Fire!
Some have greatness thrust upon them. From January 1, SF will be replaced by sci-fi. Your gateway to fantastic worlds, amazing stories, and exclusive original movies.
We live in a unique place, a new world.
Sci-fi, imagine greater.
I've always thought that Weather Channel watchers really appreciate the spectacular landscapes that make up our great southern land. And they've proven it again. The awe-inspiring, breathtaking and the totally serene.
Go to shop.skynews.com.au to buy yours.
Welcome back to Your Property Empire. Now tonight I'm joined by Naomi Simpson from Red Balloon, who's sharing some of her stories as an entrepreneur and how she got into the property market as well. So we were talking before the break and obviously doing some renovating. Hindsight's a wonderful thing. Looking back at your kind of 20 years property investing, is there anything that you changed? Do you do a bit differently?
Yeah, there is. One of the things is you're often always waiting out for the top bid or the best, but a house is only worth, or a property is only worth, what somebody is prepared to pay for it. So I remember there was one property that we, you know, we said, no, it's worth more than that, it's worth more than that. And then we couldn't get that at auction, so we passed it in. Then all of the purchases disappeared, so we put tenants in it. The tenants didn't do a particularly nice job of looking after it. It was actually worth less the year after. So I wish we actually had sold it, got the money and moved on rather than waiting.
And so sometimes even having it completely vacant is better than someone trashing it.
Yes, of
course. If you've made it
exactly.
Absolutely beautiful.
We had to repaint it, more carpets, you know, the whole thing.
So So, for a lot of the young people just starting out, what would you say are some of the golden rules that people should kind of stand by when it comes to property investing?
Look, I am very conservative, so I don't think you should put all your eggs in one basket. And I definitely think that you should know what the potential upside is. Make sure there's a market for it. That is, if you buy something way out in a suburb or somewhere that people have never really heard of and it's not a growth corridor, so I would look at growth corridors, where people are going. I'd look at where infrastructure is going in each of the cities, and that's where I would choose, because you've got to have a demand for your property at the end, and the more people that are demanding it, the less likely you're going to have only one bidder on the day.
Now, a lot of people build a business or have a job to then save up to buy a property. I think you did it in reverse. You started with the property and then got into business. Can you tell me how that was good for business?
Twofold. One is, when I was starting Red Balloon, is I wanted to keep overheads low. So if you own your own home, you're not paying rent. And that's a really good thing, apart from the second-hand computers and all of the rest of it. So keeping overheads low is very important when you're starting out. And as they say, the Americans call it bootstrapping. You know, we just were, you know, starting a business from home. It wasn't that complex. The other thing is that you can use the capital in your business to actually fund your growth. So you can borrow from the bank and use it as working capital to fund your growth. So there's many ways that real estate can be useful, but one is not having to pay rent, which was very, very great for my cash flow.
But it is great having that asset behind you, because I know when I kind of got into business, because when you start a business, you never make any money, do you?
No.
Like they say, like most businesses fail in 5 years. Well,
yeah.
Most of the time you never make a profit in business, because you're always reinvesting it,
yeah.
Especially if you've got a really good business. And so it's having that backup plan at the same time, isn't it? Having that property that's solid bricks and mortar, and the banks love it.
Banks love it. You can borrow against it, but it also gives you the security and the confidence that you might take a few more risks in your business than you otherwise would. So in other words, if you've got a roof over your head, you've got somewhere to live and somewhere to sleep, it takes the pressure off.
So you're obviously kind of pretty aligned with the business and the property side. Is it all kind of business, or is there a bit of pleasure in there as well?
Oh, look, I'm always having a good time. There's lots of things that I do. You know, I've got teenagers and we have a good time together, and there's always holidays or things, and there's yoga, and I do look after myself. Yeah, no, it's definitely, and I do like a holiday or two, travelling. Yeah.
Now, I guess this is the hard question. I go to a lot of high net worth conferences and they talk about how to try and get your kids motivated. How have you, I guess, dealt with the kids and pocket money and trying to get them into the housing? Because, I mean, your kids are kind of just coming out of school, really, aren't they?
Yeah, so...
Is there an education process at home, or is that pretty hard?
Look, we're pretty... They have an allowance, and everything has to come out of that. And we say, don't ask us for more, you've just got to manage your cash yourself. It's that simple. You know, they've both been out there trying to get jobs, but it's not always that easy. So I think the challenge really for... But you know what's great is Airtasker. Have you ever tried that? So that's great for the teenagers when they just look for babysitting or walking a dog or something that's not regular, but they just need a little bit of cash and pocket money.
So what's it called?
Airtasker.com.au.
Right, okay.
Fantastic. So that's great for kids. There's also One Shift when they're just looking for part-time work. But we're very keen that if they want to have a way of life, and I do find it amusing when, you know, my daughter says, oh, mummy, you know, such and such bought for their 18th birthday a car, and I say, poor them, they'll never understand the value of money.
But it is a hard thing as a parent. I mean, my kids are like 4 and 6, and we're trying to teach them that they can't just get another iPad, and if it breaks, then you just buy another one.
I remember Oscar wanting one of those, you know, those games like an Xbox or one of those things. He goes, Mum, why can't we have them? I said, it's very expensive. He goes, you can afford it. And I said, yes, but I choose not to spend my money on that. You can choose what you... And in fact, he said, as soon as he got pocket money, the first thing he said, can we get Foxtail? We meant Foxtel, the telly.
Yeah. Obviously, I mean, that's a very necessary thing for education.
Exactly.
Exactly.
That's what he wanted to spend his pocket money on.
So going back to, I guess, some of the business owners, is it a good thing for them to get into property, do you think, as well as building their businesses, to have that backup plan and to have a way of raising money for the business?
Look, raising money is important, but look, when you're in business, it is about focus. So I wouldn't say diversify too much and get distracted. I'd do something simple, something obvious, and, you know, don't bet everything, because you do need to focus on your business. You need to focus on your customers, you need to be listening to them, and you need to be adapting and innovating the whole time. So if you're too distracted with that, so I would look at something that is not too risky and something that you can have some confidence in.
And I guess that's one of the arguments to go for property over shares anyway, isn't it? Because especially if you're not renovating the property and you're buying it, once you've bought it, you've got tenants in, it's almost set and forget anyway. So you can have that property as a side, as an asset growing, while you're concentrating 99% of the time on the business.
My theory is people have always got to live somewhere. So as long as it's a reasonable looking property, then it just makes lots of sense. You never know what's going to go on inside a company. We've had great Australian businesses go belly up, of which nobody thought that that was going to happen. So there's no guarantees in the share market. Not saying there's guarantees in property either, but if you do your work, understand where growth is coming from, something that's very rentable for people who have to live somewhere, it makes sense.
Right, some good advice there. Anyway, time now for a quick break. We'll be back again soon.
World Vision works with parents so children can attend school and avoid early marriage. But we need your support. Help protect a childhood this Christmas. Sponsor a child today. Call 133240 or visit worldvision.com.au.
Now there's an easier way to floss. Introducing the Philips Sonicare Air Floss. With a totally clean mouthfeel in just 60 seconds.
By shopping small, you made a big difference. So to the many who shopped small, here's a big thank you. Keep thinking big, keep shopping small. American Express. Realise the potential.
Net worth is about $6 million.
$2.5 million.
$1.5 million.
$1.2 million.
$4 million.
They have wealth and success, but they can't find love. Enter the Millionaire Matchmaker.
Why love now?
I'm a better person.
In a brand new season.
Still hot.
Can she play Cupid to the rich and clueless?
Whoa. You couldn't get these girls.
Girls over 30, they're uptight and their face looks like leather.
Millionaire Matchmaker starts Thursday, January 9, first on Arena.
Glory of God is all around us, Hannah. Trees, frogs, birdie birds.
I hate this.
Can you believe that my friend told me she'd die because she didn't want to hang out with me?
Yeah, no, I totally get that.
Excuse me?
I am okay. I may not seem okay and I may not be okay now, but I'm like, okay.
My life is a mess, and I know that was a personal choice, but I feel like maybe it is time for me to unchoose that choice.
I'm trying to follow the protocols of a gentleman and a squire.
I don't hate your friends. I'm just not interested in anything they have to say.
I'm not interested in anything they have to say. That's not the point of friendship.
Who is Hannah Horvath?
I feel like I'm a person who just, like, can't keep my mouth shut.
Everything that's been so terrible and painful in the last few months was leading me to this point, you know? And it's amazing to realize that I hold the keys to the prison that is my mind.
My head's caught.
Welcome back to the show. Tonight we're interviewing one of the key entrepreneurs from the Entrepreneurs Organisation in Sydney, Naomi Simpson from Red Balloon Day. Oh, sorry, Red Balloon. I know it's all changed now. Tell us a bit more about shared experience and happiness.
Yeah, look, Red Balloon, you know, one of the reasons for our success, I believe, is that when you give a gift, part of the joy of giving a gift is that you get to share it. And there is a great movement against stuff, because we all have a lot of stuff, and even in, you know, storage, you know, people need to go to bigger houses because they need store stuff. So there's been a great movement towards experiences, doing things with people that they love, and that's shared experience. And shared experience gives happiness. And that's what we're all about at Red Balloon.
And so how does that relate to property?
You know, home, you know, what about the movie The Castle? Isn't that the answer? Man's home is his castle. So it's not just, I think deep in our core of being Australian is about the home, and also about, you know, bricks and mortar gives us some level of security and assault, and you know, banks love bricks and mortar, they do love that, so it balances it out. But shared experience in the home, in your home, of knowing that you don't have to move, knowing that your lease isn't going to expire, knowing that you can make it how you'd like. You know, if you want to set up your pool room, you go right ahead and set up that pool room just the way you like it. And I think that's really important, and that is about shared experience. So material goods, when they're shared, give the experience of happiness. So, you know, nobody says, oh, look at my new couch. It's the conversations you have on the couch which make it a wonderful couch.
Now, I guess people are wired differently. So to some people, the security of their own home and doing whatever they want to it is the best thing on earth, and that's what makes them sleep at night. Other people think, God, getting into debt and having liabilities and all the rest of it could be the worst thing in the world. So how do we maybe change some of these people's thought processes to say, well, no, it actually can be a good thing for you?
Well, it can be. Interest rates are at their lowest in ever since before I was born, which is a pretty long time ago. So interest rates are at their lowest ever. Now, if you are unsure about what's going to happen with interest rates, the banks will fix those interest rates so you know that your exposure. The other thing is that, you know, you can make sure that the when I think about it, if you were to have any savings, you're not going to get a great deal of return on that in any fixed term or deposit, or you can put in share markets or other things. Again, there's no guarantee of return. So if I thought about it, I would argue if you've got to pay rent anyway, you may as well be paying interest to the bank. And I'm sure the banks love me saying that. But, you know, if you're going to pay rent, you may as well get on this, and you'll end up, because your superannuation that you're putting may not be enough for your retirement to keep
you. It's almost
you
a guarantee that it's not, isn't it?
Well, that's what they're saying now. They're now saying that $1 million in retirement is not enough. And the return that you're going to get on that to maintain your lifestyle. So you have to do other things apart from just thinking, oh, my superannuation is my retirement. It won't be enough. But if you own your own home and you don't have the constant rent requirement when you get to retirement and you own it outright, life is looking much better for you.
But the forced savings thing is one of the key things to property investing and making money, whether you're into shares or property or anything else, because no one kind of saves that much money. So no matter what you earn, and you'd see a whole diverse range of kind of income earners in your business as well, but people generally won't save that money, will they? Unless someone's going to stand over with a stick, i.e. the bank, and say, right, you've got to pay your mortgage, most people won't save.
No, because it's there to be spent.
Yeah.
And unless there's a purpose and a goal.
And especially when they're in an experience company, when they've got helicopter rides and fast car rides and diving with sharks.
And, you know, massages, yeah, and chocolate walking tours, all of those things. So, yeah, I think it's because there's no sense of urgency around that. And that is, oh, I'll do it tomorrow, and tomorrow never comes.
So what would you say are the biggest gems for people out there that want to get into business or want to get into property investing? What are the key things that they should be doing?
Look, I always think is don't try and think 20 years out, but what does 5 years from now look like? And, you know, you might not be able to imagine that right now, but if you don't dream, dreams never come true. So whether it's starting a business, and I always say to people, don't start a business if you think it's going to make you rich, because actually you're probably better off having a job, because most businesses don't return, and they do take
your
life.
You're the last one to get paid.
That's right, if at all. So then on the other side, it's the same with a home or an investment property. What do you want your dream to look like? And if you only look 5 years out, you can fix interest rates for 5 years with a bank, and then you're going to have a sense of where you're going. But you do, you know, to go on a journey, you've got to take the first step.
Now, completely away from the property side of things, with the thousands of experiences that you guys have gone through, what are one or two of the favourites?
Look, we see so many trends coming through, and it depends where you are in the country, but we're seeing some very exciting things. Believe it or not, restaurants are going really well, and also cooking classes. I know you like a cooking class, Chris, but the reason, every time they put a cooking show on television, everyone goes, oh, great idea, what a great gift. So such a variety of different ones. So gourmet's really big this Christmas.
The key thing that I've learned, the same as my property investing, is there's always someone that can do it better than me, so it's better to outsource and ring the restaurant rather than do it yourself. Thanks for joining us this evening. Really great to get some good advice there. And thanks for joining us this evening at home. I hope you've enjoyed the special show. Now, next week I'm going to be interviewing EO member Jeremy Levitt from a company called Service Seeking. His company has facilitated over $1 billion of renovations. So if you'd like to get an idea of what are the latest trends and how to get the work done at a reasonable cost, tune in again next Friday. Until then, I'm Chris Gray. Good night.
The information featured in this program is general in nature and therefore should not be relied upon. Guests appearing on the program may have commercial arrangements with some of the companies mentioned. Before making any investment, insurance or financial planning decisions, you should consult a licensed professional who can advise whether your decision is appropriate for you.
We're here.
And we're here.
We're here.
Here.
And here.
We're here.
Here.
And we are here.
Holden has been here for over 100 years. And while in the future, we'll no longer make cars in Australia, we'll always be committed to making the best cars for Australia. That's something that'll never change.
Because we're here to stay.
World Vision works with parents so children can attend school and avoid early marriage, but we need your support. Help protect a childhood this Christmas. Sponsor a child today. Call 1332 40 or visit worldvision.com.au.
My net worth is about $6
million. $2.5
million. $1.5
million. $1.2
million.
$4
million.
They have wealth and success, but they can't find love. Enter the Millionaire Matchmaker.
Why love now?
I'm a better person.
In a brand new season.
Still hot.
Can she play Cupid to the rich and clueless?
Whoa. You couldn't get these girls.
Girls over 30, they're uptight and their face looks like leather.
Millionaire Matchmaker starts Thursday, January 9, first on Arena.
From this summer, there's a fresh way for everyone to enjoy music on Foxtel. With 30 ad-free audio channels, the new Foxtel Tunes is your place to find music for any mood. No matter what you're into, it's totally uninterrupted and has all the brands you know and love. Head over to Channel 830 and check it out. Foxtel Tunes. We've got your music lineup covered.
Glory of God is all around us, Hannah! Trees, frogs, birdie birds.
I hate this.
Can you believe that my friend told me she'd die because she didn't want to hang out with me?
Yeah, no, I totally get that.
Excuse me?
I am okay. I may not seem okay and I may not be okay now, but I'm like, okay.
My life is a mess, and I know that was a personal choice, but I feel like maybe it is time for me to unchoose that choice.
I'm trying to follow the protocols of a gentleman and a squire.
I don't hate your friends. I'm just not interested in anything they have to say.
I'm not interested in anything they have to say. That's not the point of friendship.
Who is Hannah Horvath?
I feel like I'm a person who just, like, can't keep my mouth shut. Everything that's been so terrible and painful in the last few months was leading me to this point, you know? And it's amazing to realize that I hold the keys to the prison that is my mind. My head's caught.
I've always thought that Weather Channel watchers really appreciate the spectacular landscapes that make up our great southern land. And they've proven it again. The awe-inspiring, breathtaking and the totally serene.
Go to shop.skynews.com.au to buy yours.
Kennedy won.
We might call it dog with a bone.
We'll canvass the best economists in the business.
It's really a vastly uncapped opportunity.
There are some adjustments to the threshold.
Commodity prices go up and down. I know that because I watch Sky Business.
It was like a no-brainer.
Well, kind of the final finish to our product.
We have made progress.
It has been a lot of twists and turns.
There's a lot of fuel for rally.
Game-changing market announcements.
That's going to work. It's been a cocktail fairy tale.
With the voices of experience.
Uncharted territory.
What better way to judge the global economic health?
The country's top money men and women.
A big focus.
This is Sky News Business, Australia's business channel. The information featured in this program is general in nature.